So let's write some Python code to solve this particular example. So here's a translation of that problem and the solution into Python. So first, I have a list of the connections in that graph that we're just looking at, nodes A through H. And for each of these pairs, I go through and make a link in a graph G. And then I run a piece of code to list the component sizes for that graph G. And here's what the output looks like, and then we'll go back and look at what the algorithm is. It goes through and identifies that there's two components. One we'll just name little a because it contains node little a. There's four nodes in it, and then there's a separate component that's not connected to the first one that contains b, and that also has four nodes. And in fact, looking back at the graph here, that's exactly what we see. There's the purple nodes, which include node a, and then there's these blue-green nodes, four of which are visible here, that include B. So it finds the right stuff. So how does it go about doing this? Well, it essentially uses the same algorithm that I did when I was doing it by hand, but of course it does it in code. The main routine that we call is called mark component. So that's kind of like what I was doing when I was turning nodes purple. And it works like this. We give it the graph that we're working on, the current node that we're marking, and a data structure that keeps track of which things have been marked so far. Call this routine on this node, and so that's a new node. We haven't seen it before, so we mark it. So that means we've visited that node, and we say that in this particular call to the routine, so far we've marked exactly one node. Then we look at all the neighbors of that node, and for each of them, we say, well, if that neighbor of the node that we're looking at hasn't been marked so far, then what we're going to do is recursively call mark component on that neighbor. It's going to go and get everywhere that it can get to that it hasn't already gotten to, mark them all, and return. And what it returns is the number of nodes that it marked as part of this process. And however many nodes it marked, we're going to add that to the total marked. So we marked our current node, then we visited a neighbor and marked all the nodes connected to that neighbor. Then we come back and repeat this loop for all the different neighbors of the node where we started. When that's exhausted, it means we've now reached out and touched all the nodes that are touchable from node node. And so we return the total that were actually marked as part of this process, and then it's done. So that's the main routine that does all the hard work. There's also a routine on the outside that takes a graph and starts off saying, well, nothing's been marked so far. We just have an empty data structure. Then what we're going to do is we're going to loop through all the nodes in the graph, because we don't know which ones are going to be the beginnings of a new component or not. For each one that we visit, we say, well, if that node hasn't been marked in some previous iteration, then we've got a new component, and this node that we're just visiting is a part of that component. So we say, hey, we've got a component containing node node, and then what we do is we recursively go and mark all the things connected to that node, count up how many things got marked in that way, and then we return. So that what we know is there was a component, it contained node node, and it has a certain count to it. When it's done that, it moves on to the next node. A bunch of these have probably already been marked, so they just get skipped really quickly. But eventually, it maybe reaches a node that hasn't been marked because it wasn't connected to anything so far. Prints that one out and continues. So this really is very explicitly what we were doing by hand, just one piece at a time.